play with Callisto. How am I? I'm tired. I'm very, very tired. When will what come out for Rogue Trader? Beta? Early access? Full game? This closed beta should be now, in December. Early access should be mid-2023. And the full release should be at the beginning of 2024. That should be the order. I'll start creating content day one when it's available, so you'll know. Like, I'll be among the first to cover the game. It's the only game I'm looking forward to, after all. I believe Baldur's Gate 3 will have final release first, before Rogue Trader. The drills of servers. Planet of exploitation. Man, I forgot controls for this game. Don't drown. I easily forgot controls. I haven't played for a few days and I forgot controls. Gonna be out. Should be tomorrow, but I don't know when it's gonna be out. Frankly, I don't have a rush for Callisto Protocol. The entire world is gonna play Callisto Protocol because there's nothing else left till the end of the year. So I got a full freaking month to decide when I wanna do it. Jesus Christ, man. Now. Less than 20 hours, gonna be 12, 14 hours game. Every survival horror is like that. Especially when you decide to go with a second run, it's gonna be 6 hours. It's a short game. You're just hyped because there's nothing else. Extremely hyped. They picked the right time to release Callisto Protocol. Nothing is out. Absolutely not. Jesus Christ! I'm dead. I didn't know water level is supposed to go up like this. Holy shit! We gotta chase now. Okay. I'll speed it up.
A distraught bee looks toward the sunken body of her friend. She pays no attention to the fact that by destroying the drill, she has released the powerful being held inside. The giant squid turns out to be more than a despicably exploited slave, and perfectly understands the subtle signals around her. The surrounding space stretches before her eyes as the squid proudly soars toward the starry sky. Flooded drills, the desert turning green, the black space, and a planet in the distance. Bee sees all of it at once, blurred and connected. Just as the surrounding colors turn from beiges to amethysts, so do the initial surprise and trust turn to uncertainty. After all, the squid does not land, but continues to fly through the clouds. High above the crystal-encrusted surface of the unexplored planet. Bee smells the metallic scent of electronics even before other squids emerge from the mist. Their bodies are brutally constricted by saddles, with electro-spear-wielding riders standing atop them. They attack. They shoot. The new giant friend writhes in pain. Then drops B and Rose into the chasm.
Aviat, Eteral Planet.
car.
Sides. God damn it, Hal. I'm supposed to drag the ball here. Right. How am I supposed to do that? Okay. No! Need that thing. Yes. Saving baby squid. Is it timed? It's timed. Holy shit! Thank you. What is this? How do I rotate? Okay.
Eris heats the altar in a violent outburst, which B dodges at the last moment. A pillar of fire shoots toward the sky through a breach in the cave ceiling and draws the attention of several patrols flying nearby. Rose is slowly returning to life, nourishing herself on the warmth offered by the goddess. By the time she regains her strength, however, it will be too late. She can only watch as the riders abduct B and force the fighting squids to retreat. B's resistance comes too late, and the riders' stun weapons render her unconscious. She is awakened only by the screeching of metal and its cold aftertaste, rising along with the burning stench of electronics. Crackling and explosions can be heard in the distance. The riders panic and disappear, while B trembles in a corner, wondering what might be happening. Rose charges in at full speed from behind the door and hits the battery with all her might.
Where are we? Name of the map. Oh, we got those now. Release the baby squids to destroy the antenna. Send of transmission. Still on a via. Okay, my bad. Fuck. Dante Anaxi, how you doing, people? What's Hogwarts Legacy? Is that that Harry Potter thing, yeah? You know, I never watched a single Harry Potter movie in my life. I can't stand it. So 99%, I won't be playing it. Jesus Christ. What the telekinesis here for? What? At least 4 out of 6. Destroy the antennas. And it's 6 out of 6. Telekinesis. What was the point of telekinesis? Raise 7 squids and destroy antennas. I already installed Pentiment. Maybe once I'm done with this, because I doubt there's much more left.
AI made us riders. What are we to be now? Shouts Pluto, the defeated rider commander. Above him, the source of his great power, the relay antenna, falls. The squids refuse to obey. They throw themselves at the remaining structures in their fight for freedom. B escapes the battle raging in the relay. But somewhere along the way, she loses contact with Rose. The enemy does not miss this opportunity. When the Wisp comes back into view, it is wearing a collar with an ominous technological appearance. It displays a huge hologram as if to extend a greeting. B is well aware of who is before her and has never been so terrified. Rose's fire is no longer as gentle and pleasantly warm as before, and is beginning to burn in places. Bee senses an unnatural trembling of the flames that hold her. Rose carries Bee to one of the transport capsules on the sidelines, and tosses her inside before bursting into an unexpected explosion of heat. Tiny flashes of a warm orange hue are the last vestige of hope. The door suddenly slams shut as the capsule carries B off into the sky.
Junkyard. Through the trash, sticks, planet of junk. Oh, shit, it's voids. I don't have double jump anymore, by the way, but I lost Rose. Thank you. What is this? The purple time aura makes me younger. Or better to say smaller. The orange time aura ages me. Search the junkyard. Only young bee can squeeze through narrow tunnels. Jesus Christ. You troll. I can't go back with that. Thank you. No. Oh. I destroyed the other one. The reset. There's only one rack. Shoot! I'm older now, I can jump. Yeah, bullshit. Blue one makes you younger. Then you can be a pup. When you're a pup, you can squeeze through. Orange one turns you back, or if you step the second time into orange one, it makes you old, which means you cannot jump. That's the entire point. Doesn't reset. And I need to stay clear from getting old. And I just got old. And I can't jump anymore. Jesus! And if I'm young, then I'll fucking freak out. No! gets old. I don't know how. Sentiment is already out for days now. I got old no matter what. It's just fucking crazy. You can't jump that far. See a way. Old B can't be damaged by toxic scents. Really? Let's get old. Yes. I'm all that I got. Search the junkyard. Get me younger. Daddy. And drop. What a flying fuck is this? Younger. 10. Now what? I can pass. Together again. What killed me in the water? What on earth? It's the spikes. Okay. Just need to be patient. Dropping platform now because I'm heavy. Yeah. No, see, I got old in a minta.
This tinkerer is the only living thing around. Who better to seek help from, if not him? B still hasn't decided whether she should attempt contact, or whether it is better to sneak past after all.
We're gonna pass. So much from that. Ah, you're aggressive, eh? Time bit. Oh my god, it makes you older when it shoots at you. Yes. That's what. Favorite roguelite? I don't know, to be honest. I play them all, but I don't have a favorite, I guess. Perhaps Samum Aeterna, but it's still in early access. Don't tell me you can shoot through that. Motherfucker!
B's memories caused the Tinkerer to feel for her and create a thread of understanding between them. He reveals his name, Phlegius, and proposes a journey homeward, as far as Eris will allow. Phlegius uses his clock power and creates a transport field. They disappear from the planet, oblivious that they have a stowaway who barely made it within range of the teleport. While defending himself against the manipulated Rose, Phlegius frees her from the AI's influence. However, the resulting explosion blasts B away. B arrives and is greeted by thunderous cheers and applause. The familiar scent of the forest and its inhabitants comforts her, but also makes her irrationally anxious. Was this road here before? The Drydens trust B more than they used to, which is why they have revealed it. A sarcophagus deep in the ground heralds her next task. The memory of a wrist blocking Bobby's path suddenly returns and makes her think and hesitate. But the Drydens are everywhere, crowding around B, encouraging her.
We're on the first planet where the game started, by the way. Sarcophagus of Eris. At least I can double jump again. Ah, shit is this now? How am I supposed to know what's the right one? Delius, feasty, thanks for the sub. Thanks for the 6 months. To make a top 10 roguelikes, I would need days to assemble the list. And to think about it. Thank you. 4. And Delius, thanks again. Thanks. Got 6. That easy. Lucky too. What now? Kinesis.
Joyful cheers turn to screams of terror. B abruptly awakens after losing consciousness. Certain that if the Drydens feel they must run from something, she does too.
Their sight and the portals to reach the switches. Minotaur's lair. Quietly when he's listening. How on fucking earth do I get out of here?
enslaved again. Okay, I was kidding. Fuck off. Man. I don't know where. Stupid. Use your sight and the portals to reach the switches. Where is the switch? That's the good question. I don't see a switch. What's the switch here? No, that brings me back. That's bad. Where's the switch? What? Did I transfer somewhere else? Then the switch. Okay, now I get it. Now I get it. It's fine. Didn't know. Shit, then I reached everywhere. Thank God, I thought it was like four different maps of this size for the switches. It's only one. But where's the final switch? One. I'm missing something, man. I'm easily missing something. Is there a switch at the start? I didn't see a switch. No, there is not a switch here. No, 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 no. Can't even go back. Fuck is this? Uh-huh. There's something here. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. What about the other one? I think that one's closed. We need to pass through this one. I think in the final area of the game, after this, it's gonna end. That's how it looks like. Can't pass anywhere. I think. Already unlocked. Really? Great. And of course, I got a disgusting save, and I probably bugged out the game right now. Yeah, I bugged out the game right now. Yeah, I found a game-breaking bug. If I can't get out of here, and I don't have health, that's a game-breaking bug. Only I can do something like this, man. So much from the game. I see no way out of this. I see no way out of this. You can't pick levels, they just continue, and that's about it. No fucking way. I easily destroyed the game. I can't fucking believe it, okay? I just can't believe it. I mean, not that it's my fault. But this is where the game ends for me. It only has one save slot.
And you decided to save like that, man. In the middle of the shit, you decided to auto-save. And what's even worse, it auto-saves with 1 HP. There is no way to get healed back. There is no way to go to the previous save. So much from the game. There's no way I can get out. That's a game-breaking bug. Easily. That's a disaster. Shit. Can only do it like this. A full restart of the entire level. God damn it, man. God damn it, I need to do all of these puzzles again. This is the worst one. Can't believe it.
joyful cheers turn to scream.
Great, it one-shots. Great. I see the switches. Okay. Fucking area is bugged. Supposed to go to the right side. I don't see the switches. And I don't see how to pass at all.